The Kelly gang have been holding up banks for as long as, well, for as long as they've been banks. Historically, we were the world's first biker gang. But what really set us apart from all the other outlaws was our philosophy. We always gave everything we stole to the poor. My Uncle Dan had been the most notorious Aboriginal outlaw of all time, until he retired to run the family pub. My brother Joe was the gang's tax expert, and the rest of the gang worked full-time in the manufacture and consumption of beer.
Come on, Ned! You'll be late for work!
Wabang, you make my heart sing.
Yep, times had changed all right. The entire bank robbing division of the once world-famous Kelly gang had been reduced to just one man. Me. We lived in this wild pub. It was so old that no one was sure if it was actually built or just somehow grew out of the ground. And over the years, it had become home to just about every kind of wildlife you can imagine. Apart from my dog, my bike was my best mate. I personally built it from the wheels up out of scrap metal. Sure, it had a few minor structural problems and it wasn't exactly mechanically perfect, but everyone respected it, especially Joe.
Morning, Dan.
Good morning, Ned.
It is refueled.
Thanks, Joe.
You still haven't fixed that leaking pump.
Have now. Our pub was on the shore of a national park, hundreds of miles from anywhere. I reckon it was as close to paradise as you can get. Riding to work that day, nothing seemed different from any other day. At least, that's what I thought at the time.
Good morning. I'd like to make a withdrawal.
Enter PIN number.
It's a 44.
Check out the dickhead talking to a machine.
That's no dickhead. That's Ned Kelly.
Oh, yeah.
This transaction is terminated.
I don't think so.
Ouch! Computer malfunction.
Bingo.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. This is the Kelly gang. And I'd like to make a deposit.
Deposit?
Yeah. Deposit this money amongst the bank accounts of any people who can't repay their loans. And I want receipts, and I want them now.
Wait, wait. Don't shoot. I will get all the stuff onto it.
All officers, take your position.
It was then I heard something you very rarely hear in the middle of a bank robbery. Shakespeare.
If music be the food of love, play on, give me excess of it. If music be the food of love.
And who are you?
Robin Banks,
I was earlier. Now I'm depositing.
This is my lunch break.
I love American accents.
Excuse me.
I like the way you talk. In fact, I like everything about America. What you reading?
Shakespeare.
I hate flies.
Monsieur Kelly, all the people are seeing.
Thanks, mate.
This time is trapped.
Hey. Maybe I'll see you later.
I doubt it, cowboy. Bye, Ned.
Wait for it.
What's the matter, boys?
Robbing people with a six gun. I bought the law and the long one. I bought the law and the long one. I needed money cause I had none. I bought the law and the long one. I bought the law and the long one. I left my baby and it feels so bad. I guess my race is wrong. She's the best girl that I ever had. I fought the law and the law won. I fought the law and I lost my girl and I lost my son. I fought the law and the law won. I fought the law and the law won.
I didn't know it at the time, but I just triggered off a chain of events that was to threaten the very existence of the Kelly Gang.
Lovers cannot see the pretty follies that themselves commit, for if they could, Cupid himself would blush.
The outlaw dropped this. Take it to Sir John's office immediately.
Ed Kelly has robbed yet another branch of the International Trust Bank, but this time his target was head office. The bank's largest foreign investors have responded by threatening to pack up and go home. However, locals are reacting quite differently.
Ed Kelly's deadly. He's great.
Yeah, he's wonderful. Yeah, he's fabulous.
He's the one who gives us the cash.
He's got a great bike.
Since Ned Kelly has been depositing money in our bank account, I can afford more groceries. Look!
Through their haphazard program of redistributing money, the Kelly Gang has effectively lowered interest rates, cut inflation, and raised the standard of living for the average family.
Rotten bastards.
It's been Ned Kelly's complete disregard for authority that has captured the hearts of the people and made him something of a national hero.
Yes?
Sir John, one of our young tellers has some information regarding the robbery.
What is it?
Apparently, this was dropped during the holdup. Oh, Sir John, there is also a Major Whibb here to see you.
Yes, come in.
Major Whibb from Great Britain, sir. Formerly of Her Majesty's personal guards. 5 years Scotland Yard, 3 years Royal British Commandos, served with distinction, Special Forces Intelligence Branch. At your service, vis-a-vis the Kelly problem.
It's very impressive, Major.
Thank you, Sir John. I had the pleasure of being on duty at Buckingham Palace the day you got your knighthood.
Oh, really?
Yes, rah-rah, poo-poo, sir.
It's about time we had a man of your particular talents working exclusively for us in the field of corporate banking.
If you'll pardon the pun, sir, I plan to make a killing.
Thank you, that'll be all.
Please, Major. Now, what do you make of this?
It's a toweling mat, commonly used on the top of Australian hotel bars for the absorption of beer spillage.
Looks like some sort of a rodent. Is it a rat?
It's a kangaroo, sir. The Glenrowan Hotel.
It's in a national park called Reckless Island. No wonder the police have never been able to track them down. According to this, it's a remote wilderness.
It'll be a tough one. Kelly would know that island like the back of his hand. The first sign of armed aggression, he'd vanish into the bush and pick us off like flies.
Yes, you're right. Major, the one thing you'll learn in business that almost anything can be achieved by having good political connections. Miss Twisty, draft a confidential fax to the Department of National Parks. Tell them that the bank will be acting as the sole agent for the sale of Reckless Island.
Right away, Sir John. You can't sell a national park.
Webb! I'm going to turn Kelly's hideout into a Japanese tourist resort.
It down by the jets it landed, where the monsters bombed. The others read it standing like Scots of the Antarctic. Base camp too far away. She don't like that kind of behavior. She don't like that kind of behavior.
For Kelly, getting shot was an occupational hazard. But I guess over the years, we must have developed some sort of natural tolerance. Unfortunately, I still had to spend a heck of a lot of time digging out bullets.
Good morning, ma'am. How may the bank help you?
I'm taking out a loan.
Oh, my God. It's the Hollywood Outlaw. Don't kill me.
I've never killed anyone. I only shoot guns from the hands of those who would prefer to see me dead. Now, hand over the money. I've got some shopping to do.
Hey, right where you are.
I'm beginning to regret the day I let you put a video store in this pub.
All you and that dog ever do is look at that same dumb movie.
Hey, we were watching that. I'm getting shot to pieces and for what? We've got the biggest turnover of any bank robbers in the country and we haven't even got enough money to fix up the pub.
Using stolen money for our own benefit would be against every principle upon which the Kelly Gang was founded.
Dan was right, of course, but robbing from the rich and giving to the poor sure wasn't easy, like it was in Robin Hood's day.
I could use some help with the stamps.
I used to deposit so much money in so many people's bank accounts that we could spend all afternoon just mailing out receipts.
Oh. Oh, look.
Been shot in the lung again. course, that was nothing compared with my dad. He was still listed in the Guinness Book of Records as the world's most frequently shot human being.
You're very lucky. You've got your father's bulletproof constitution.
A little lower, I think, Uncle Dan. That's it.
Okay. Ready?
Yep. Band-Aids. Ah, thanks. I gotta do something about getting shot all the time.
And there it was, a bulletproof garbage can.
Come on, then, it's happy hour.
Yeah, pass the beer.
Hurry up, Ned. Banks close at 5, you know.
Morning, dog.
Ready? Cornflakes. No, fella. Corn flakes. Cornflakes. Come on, talk. Keep practicing. Mr. Kelly.
Yes! Yes!
We're all Kellys, mate.
You have a letter.
A letter?
A letter? A letter! A letter.
The International Trust Bank will be acting as sole agent for the sale of Reckless Island.
What? Oh. According to this document, our island is going to be relocated to Tokyo Bay, Japan.
What? I loathe this weather. I loathe this country.
Quite right, Sir John. After a cold, foggy, drizzly English morning, eh?
I reckon this flag needs a slight modification.
What the hell's going on in here? That's the British flag.
We'll take it back to Britain.
You're a larrikin, Kelly. You have absolutely no respect for authority.
You're not selling our island.
There's obviously an informer working somewhere in the bank.
Well, I won't be working here for long.
We've brought in every birth certificate of every Kelly who was born on Reckless Island.
Yeah. They go back quite a long way.
It proves that the Kellys have lived there in one form or another for at least 40,000 years. The first person to land on the island was an Aborigine named Awaba Kelly.
This is his birth certificate.
So what?
That makes Reckless Island Kelly tribal land.
So us Kellys legally have first right of purchase.
Fine, but you'll have to match the Japanese offer of $1 million.
No problem.
Oh, really? You'll never raise the cash.
Aren't you forgetting something, mate? The Kelly gang robs banks.
Yes, but the Kelly gang gives all its money to the poor.
We were in deep trouble, all right. So we headed to the brewery to do some thinking. It was there that I found out this wasn't the first time Reckless Island had been under threat.
Legend has it that it's about an ancient battle in which the first inhabitants saved the island from evil invaders.
No kidding.
It's all part of Aboriginal mythology. You know, Ned, the dreaming. I suppose it doesn't make any sense in a modern world.
But if we could make it make sense, maybe everything that doesn't make sense would make sense.
Eh?
You do enough dreaming for everyone around here. In again, eh?
Yes, he was up all night. I think he was building something. What are you doing with that can on your head?
I'm going bank robbing.
You go robbing a bank in that garbage can outfit, and you'll wreck the entire image of the Kelly gang.
What are you wearing it for?
So I don't get shot.
With a bulletproof armor suit, I can rob a lot of banks real fast and use the money to buy the island back.
Huh? Any money the Kelly gang gets in this country belongs to the people of this country.
And why don't we rob banks in another country? I'm telling you, for an outlaw, America is a land of opportunity. Even a little kid knows that in America, when people rob banks, they get to keep all the money themselves.
You've been looking at too many movies.
Look,
there's only one way to save this island. It's called free enterprise.
Suddenly, I was on my way to the USA, home of bank robbing legends like Jesse James, Bonnie and Clyde, and the Hollywood Outlaw.
What's the purpose of your trip to the United States?
Business.
Your accountants had hidden talents.
So,
what's this big discovery of yours?
Ned Kelly has left the gang
and gone to America.
Why would he go there?
Money.
Yes, of course. He's out to steal the $1 million to buy Reckless Island himself.
Now he's all alone in a foreign country. I think I'll pay him a visit.
You mustn't use a gun yourself. We're an international bank. We can't afford to be incriminated in America.
That's right. I'm a bank executive now.
Does that mean I get to fly in the corporate jet?
Take the correction, mildly kiss the rod, and fawn on rage with base humility, which art a lion and the king of beasts. Good night. Good night. Parting is such sweet sorrow. Sorrow. Such sweet sorrow. Parting is such sweet sorrow. Good night. Good night.
Good day.
What are you doing here?
I'm going to America.
What for?
Rob a few banks.
They say guys who carry guns have a serious personality deficiency.
Huh?
It's a prop. Tool. A crutch.
If you knew anything about bank robbing, you'd know you need a gun. Lucky the seat was empty, eh? What are you doing up here anyway?
Actually, I got fired for trying to save an island.
No kidding. That's exactly what I'm trying to do. Someone from your bank sent us a copy of a fax with... It was you. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Nice pair of dolphins.
Yeah. I think I'll go back to my book now.
Look, I'm really sorry you lost your job.
Well, I wasn't cut out for banking anyway. Maybe it was the best thing that could have happened.
Looks like we're heading to the same place.
No. No, I'm changing planes in L.A., going on to England. I'm auditioning for a new drama school at Stratford-upon-Avon.
Are you an actress?
Well, someday.
Got a boyfriend?
Over the past few years, spending every night with Shakespeare for me was norm.
Norm who?
Excuse me. I'm looking for Hollywood.
There's a sign. It is written.
Born to be wild. Born to be wild.
love you. Get on.
I'm not getting on that thing. It's filthy.
Hey, that money's not real. And that bank's not real. Hang on. I know who you are. You're the Hollywood Outlaw.
Cut it, Lyle.
Cut! Sorry. We'll have to go again, everybody.
Can I have your autograph?
Mr. DeLance!
I'm sorry, Chuck. I have no idea how this happened.
Wait a minute. You're a bloke.
Get those cameras ready.
Rockethead here rides up and says, get on the bike. Well, I'm an actor, and that's a stuntman's job.
Hey, we'll shoot it over. You're looking great, Chuck.
I can't perform anymore. I'm just too upset.
Oh, for crying out loud. I don't care who your agent is, buddy. I'm going to see to it that you never work in this town again. Who is this guy, anyway? Tin Man from The Wizard of Oz?
The name's Kelly. Ned Kelly.
I thought I must have landed on another planet. Banks weren't banks, money wasn't money, and my favorite actress had turned out to be a man. If I was going to save Reckless Island, I needed to find a real bank, and fast.
Check out the metalhead.
What are you? Undercover cop? FBI? CIA?
Bank robber.
All right.
Good evening. How may we help you, masked man?
Well, if you're the Lone Ranger, just hand over $1 million.
You're more than welcome to what we've got.
We've got a weird one holding up the Hollywood-friendly bank.
Throw it up on the big screen. That's him.
But be very careful, Lieutenant. The most dangerous place on Earth is between Ned Kelly and a bag of money.
What would you like, a line of credit?
A credit account?
A credit card?
Cash.
Okay.
Please, fill out this application form.
What for?
Well, we don't get much call for cash these days.
We have to order some in for you.
You sure I can't fix you up with some plastic?
Sam, your dinner's ready.
But Mom, it's a total fiasco. And this is where we start shooting the guns out of the actor's hands. With real bullets, for God's sake. Those cops are supposed to be winning. Look at that jerk. He's ruined the climax. He screwed up the movie.
I like him.
What?
He's a damn sight better than those ham actors you keep hiring. I mean, get a load of Chuck.
Mr. DeLance.
Are you sure this gentleman is doing an unrehearsed performance?
Absolutely. He's an animal.
That's what I thought. You better sign him up.
Sign him up?
Of course. What'd you say his name was?
Kelly. Fred Kelly. No. Ned Kelly.
Kelly? One of the great show business names. Gene Kelly, Grace Kelly.
No kidding. Hey, I better find this guy before some of the studio nabs him.
How'd the bank robbery go?
He signed you up for a credit card, right?
Right.
Listen, man, I'm gonna give you some free advice, all right? Forget that bank robbing gig. The best way to get rich quick is to do what all the smart people are doing. You got to get yourself into the entertainment business.
Ned!
baby!
In Hollywood, you steal the show. It's not what you do, it's who you know. The girls, the bucks, you'll have them all. When you're a star, they'll return your call. If you can just handle the fame, Ned Kelly will be a household name. You'll be riding in your limo, you'll be flying in your jet. Your name up in lights, your foot's in cement.
Jeepers, it's the cops!
Your nose will lift your butt. If you turn to flap, will lipo suck?
Officers ready to fire.
If you can just handle the fame, Ned Kelly will be a household. Son of a gun-loving, fun-loving, bike rider, heartbreaker, Ned Kelly will be a household name.
Nice jacket.
You're under arrest. Now hand over the guns, buddy, or you'll be wearing metal on the inside of your head.
Hey, cop, America's a free country. Every person has the right to bear arms.
Yeah.
You're about to be shot dead on nationwide television.
No TV network would stoop so low.
Welcome to Newskill, live. I'm here on Hollywood Boulevard, where some wacko with a trash can on his head is about to be blasted to pieces by the Hollywood Police Department. Right before your very eyes.
Okay, men, don't take any chances. Put two bullets apiece in his head, and then we'll break for donuts.
Hey, what's the problem, officer?
This guy's an international bank robber.
He's not a bank robber. He's an actor.
Huh? An actor?
Okay, boys. He's just an actor. Let's go.
An actor?
That's right. And legally, Hollywood police can't shoot actors. If the police start shooting actors, then the studios will close down. If that happens, there's no more movies. With no more movies, people have got nothing to believe in. Everyone gets depressed, no one bothers going to work, and the economy collapses.
Yes, 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 very sad. Now, find me some people who can shoot actors.
I had to admit that as an international bank robber, I'd been a failure. It looked like the only way to save the island now was to pretend I was an actor.
Ned, the Lance Pictures is into action movies. You know, macho heroes, sex, violence, high turnover, big profits. The quality of our movies is so high that they bypass the theaters completely and go straight to video.
Wow.
Now, do you want to know what the secret is to making big money in the video rental business?
Yeah.
The answer is one word. Guns. You see, guns aren't just guns. They're a
phallic symbol.
Yeah. The bigger the gun, the bigger the profit. Now, I know what you're thinking. Let me tell you what you're thinking. You're thinking, how am I gonna turn a nobody like you into a big star? Well, it's simple. We're gonna build you the biggest goddamn gun in Hollywood.
But Sam, aren't you forgetting something? Over 60% of video renters are women.
Mom's right. So what the heck do the women want to see?
The women want a love story.
A love story with a big gun. Brilliant. It's got everything.
Ned, to be a movie star here, you have to talk like an American.
For $1 million, I'll talk like a Martian.
$1 million? Tell you what I'll do. When the movie's finished, I'll pay you $1 million.
You got a deal.
Mom, if we can just find the right actress to play opposite Ned, then every lovesick couple, every lonely guy and gal, every family in America will be saying, let's rent a video.
It's gonna be a great movie. It's called The Christian Cowboy. It's about a gunslinging stranger who cleans up Las Vegas,
falls in love with a beautiful nun.
Look, I could be accepted into the newest Shakespearean drama school in England. I'm not gonna throw that away to be in some totally crass movie. Bye, I gotta run.
With your help, we can buy back Reckless Island and save it from ecological disaster.
You mean, if I do this movie with you, it'll save your wilderness?
It's the only chance we've got. Look, the head of the studio told me he's got the best writer in Hollywood working on the script, so it'll probably be just like Shakespeare.
Christian Cowboy, take one.
I want to thank my Jesus for the way that I feel. I'm so full of religion, I just can't be still. I want to sing it and shout it, let the people know that I'm saved by his mercy and I'm ready to go.
That's why I'm happy.
Yes, I'm happy.
Happy on my way.
Rejoicing and singing
his praises every day. For Jesus is near me and there he will stay.
That's why I'm happy.
Yes, I'm happy.
Happy on my way.
I repeat, repent, sinners. Jesus said, gambling is Satan's tool. Beware of the work of the devil, or your souls will burn in the fires of hell. Hey, look, dudes. It's the Christian Cowboy!
The word of the Lord
is the only way to your salvation.
Sinners!
And what were you doing it, I guess?
Oh, Reverend. I thank the Lord you brought that big gun to town.
Ma'am. You're a fine-looking nun. Peter, get thee to a nunnery.
Love it! Cut it, Lyle.
Freeze, Mr. Kelly. Music down. Turning off the blue screen. That's a wrap for day one.
Fantastic. Robin, you're a natural. Hey, Ned, what's the scoop with your ad-lib line? Better get thee to a nunnery?
It was Robin's idea.
Oh, it's Hamlet's line to Ophelia. It's classic Shakespeare.
Who the hell's Shakespeare?
He's only the greatest English writer of all time.
Well, he better have an American work permit. I don't want union trouble.
He died 400 years ago.
I thought it sounded stale. Let's stick to Bernie's script. You're on another winner, Bernie.
Thanks. I'm adding some extra violence.
If it's 400 years old, that means legally all his stuff is out of copyright.
What do you say?
It's free.
Hey, Bernie. On second thought, there may be something to this Shakespeare stuff. Why don't you get a hold of some of his old scripts and freshen them up a bit?
Who are you?
Big Mac Bass.
To blow your head off? Not to blow your head off? That is the question. That's the last of them.
How can the Sisters of Las Vegas ever repay you for cleaning up the rottenest town in the West?
Well, ma'am, you could kick that habit and marry me.
Oh, yes!
Amen. Lost something?
Yeah, my driver.
Where you heading?
To my hotel.
I'll give you a ride.
Okay.
Thanks, mister.
No worries.
Oh!
Climb on.
Love rides up. So a long ranger changed you into something richer and stranger, stranger than fiction, truth or the dare. I say when you come down, you say come down from where?
Ride into the future will be easy for you.
Cupid's arrow can't go through. No woman is an island, not even you. Standing here together in a new land.
Thanks for the ride. So I'll see you make up. Ciao. Oh, wait. Why don't I lend you this?
Thanks.
I gotta go. Bye.
Bye. All the world's a stage, and all the men and women merely players. They have their exits and their entrances. And each person in time plays many parts.
Oh, my. What?
Hollywood. What a place. One day you're a bank robber, the next day you're a movie star. All I had to do was finish the movie and I'd have the money. I knew everyone back home had been counting on me. It was time to tell them the good news.
Video letter. Your 20 seconds starts now.
Hi, Dan. Hi, Joe.
Video letter.
Hi, Dan. Hi, Joe.
It's Ned. Hey, I think he's wearing makeup.
You don't reckon he's turned kinky, do you?
Ooh. Guess what? I'm an actor. Gee, the time's nearly up. Well, I just wanted you blokes to know that when I finish my movie, I'll be getting one.
Get away. No photographs. Shoot.
Come on, Ernie. Hey. Let's get some autographs.
Any stars coming in this morning?
G'day, Ralph.
G'day, mate.
Mr. Kelly?
Can I have your autograph?
Sure.
Please write to Hank.
I really admire what you do. I mean, I could never be an actor. I'll be too afraid. Make mine out to Ernie.
Ms. Banks, will you be moving into a secret Hollywood love nest? And if so, with who?
Hey! There he is! Where? Where?
Ned. Do you like carrots?
Yeah.
Mr. Kelly, don't you feel that through your gratuitous use of guns on screen, you're helping to create a more dangerous society?
From an intellectual basis.
Let me handle this. Hey, smarty pants, where are you from?
New York. Oh.
Well, out here in Hollywood, it's personality questions only.
Mr. Kelly, what color underpants do you wear?
Black.
Outrageous.
Hey, you better get into makeup.
I'd like to ask Mr. Kelly another question.
Go take a meeting.
Hey, buddy, watch your language.
Why don't you keep in touch?
Hey, you keep in touch.
You keep in touch.
You keep in touch.
You keep in touch.
No! You keep in touch. Oh, I'm not gonna keep in touch, because you can keep in touch.
That's his name.
Wow.
I got Ned Kelly's autograph.
That wasn't Ned Kelly.
Who are you?
I'm the president of the Ned Kelly fan club. And I tell you, that wasn't him.
Well, who was it then?
A thief. He stole Ned Kelly's identity.
Well, he signed Ned Kelly's name.
Yeah, he wrote mine too. Look, to Ernie.
Oh, no. If he wrote your name, then he's stolen your identity too.
What do you mean?
When your identity's been stolen, you're no longer yourself. You've got no personality. You're nobody.
I want my identity back.
Automatic. Silencer. Semi-automatic. Price check. Met targets. Regular size.
You have no choice. He's stolen your identity, hasn't he?
Maybe. I haven't been feeling myself lately.
Man targets on special 995!
That's the way they operate. We believe he's an alien, possibly from another planet.
It's time to make our move. Wib, are you prepared?
Absolutely, Sir John. My people here are fully trained. All we need to do now is to get our friend in a public place alone.
Ned, the eyelashes are a big improvement. You're looking great. By the way, the women want to see you wearing a mustache.
Don't shoot, mister. It's only popcorn.
Sorry, I thought you were gonna shoot us.
Ned Kelly, one of these days you are gonna kill somebody with this thing. Guns don't solve problems, they create them. You don't need a gun. You're addicted. You're a gun addict.
I'm not addicted. I haven't fired a shot all day. I can get these things up anytime I want. Anytime at all. Feels good.
Overstretched and undercapitalized. Good.
Miss Twisty, let's send a fax.
A fax.
This fax just came through.
I'm so sorry. I can't pay you your money. They've frozen our accounts.
They foreclosed on all his loans.
And they're going to sell us off.
Who's done this?
Our bank, of course.
Bank? Which bank?
Let's try again.
This is hopeless. It's solid steel.
Hello? Hello?
Dog, how are you? It's Ned. Slow down.
What are you doing?
Talking to my dog. Now listen. Listen to me carefully. Where is Dan?
Oh. Cornflakes.
Good dog.
Is the dog talking back?
Sort of.
Stop kidding around, dog. Where's Dan?
Dog.
Dog.
Hello.
Dog?
Ned, there's a call for you.
Hello?
Just thought I'd let you know that if you're planning a trip home, you'll need a Japanese visa because I'm exporting Reckless Island tomorrow.
What's wrong?
A bunch of blokes in gray suits are taking my home.
Organized crime.
It's worse than that. They're corporate bankers.
Here's your money, Ned.
Holy cow. Mom's been laundering the company's money.
I knew that sooner or later, borrowing all that money would catch up with you. So, I have been putting aside a little something each week.
If you guys are broke, I couldn't take that money.
You must save your wilderness.
Ned, it's yours. You earned it. Besides, we need much more than $1 million to save the studio.
Yeah, they've got us. The only way we can stay in show business now is to beat that bank.
And no one has ever beaten a bank.
Well, it was the first time for everything. That bank was stealing my home. They'd hurt my friends and beaten up my dog. Enough was enough. I told you, you're not coming. It's too dangerous.
Mr. Kelly, the flight to Australia is boarding immediately. Better hurry.
So don't bother arguing anymore.
I'm not arguing anymore. Will you give me a ticket, please?
You two are traveling together?
No.
Yes. How nice. Goodbye.
Try it again. Come on, come on.
All right.
Okay, you're all clear.
Thank you, sir,
and have a nice flight. All right, next, please. Yes, please.
Flight to Australia, next boarding rows 1933 at gate 42.
Flight 673 to Barbados and Scandinavia, now leaving.
Oh, look, your fans came to say goodbye.
Hi.
Kelly!
Bon voyage.
Fair time, alien.
And I feel my finger on your trigger. Oh, yeah. I know that nobody can touch your heart. Oh, yeah. Happiness is all gonna need. Happiness is a warm, yes it is.
It's done. Two bullets, point blank range. I'm on my way back.
Good. That's the last we'll see of Ned Kelly.
Hey, look! The bullets have hit the cross!
Amen. My plan was simple. Give the bank the money and kick him off the island. Anyway, I figured Sir John had to be bluffing. You can't export an island. It's impossible.
Charges have been laid under the ocean and across the spit. The explosions will fracture the rock strata beneath the surface, breaking the island off from the mainland. Then an ocean-going tugboat will simply tow it to Japan.
Won't the island just sink?
Not with the latest Japanese technology. They've fitted the island with a series of subsurface stabilizers to provide it with flotation during the voyage. We're literally creating an offshore asset.
Gentlemen, up until now, the best undeveloped real estate has been located in the most remote places on Earth. Our bank is about to prove that cheap wilderness can be exported to the world's most wealthy industrialized country.
There's heavily armed bankers out there and you've given up guns. What can you possibly do by yourself?
Trust me.
Ned, I might not ever see you again, so whatever happens, I...
Robin, I know what I'm doing.
Now what?
Yes, the island is yours. Sayonara!
Ned!
doing?
You've all done an excellent job. I'd like you to stay on board the island until it's safely reached international waters.
Fly me back to the bank.
I'll refuel the helicopter, sir. Ricocheting our bullets with that rubbish bin suit.
Put down your guns before you kill yourselves.
Ned!
The pub's on fire.
Ned's out there and he's in trouble.
I can feel it.
Stay in here either.
Let's take all the beer we can carry and get out the back way.
You're not thinking of deserting Ned, are you?
Aim for his legs!
Legs?
Move in and shoot him in the head. No!
Oh!
great.
I'll be signed.
Oh, my head hurts.
Here's your money. Now get off our island.
Welcome home.
You business people don't know when to stop.
Remove your helmet. Unless you have friends in heaven, Kelly, you're out of luck.
Such is life. Amen.
It looked like you broke your dad's record for getting shot. Congratulations.
Guns? Looks like the Kelly gang's back in business.
Yeah, show business. When you think about it, what possible reason is there for a grown man to need a gun?